Also do, of course, have my colleague Tsepo Thobane, who is out at SAFA House, having listened to that briefing with the SAFA Chief Executive Officer, Tebogo Motlanthe, and the SAFA Technical Committee Chair, Mr. Jack Maluleka. Of course, one of the things, as I mentioned to Tulas, that was said was that there is no problem in South African football and that this is just mandatory, that a coach that does not succeed with a mandate that has been given to him, that he gets sacked. So, Tsepo, of course, you are at SAFA House at the moment and you've been listening. You guys have been hitting the SAFA CEO with a number of hard questions as to what exactly is happening. And 20 years on from when we last properly qualified for a FIFA World Cup, we've just been digressing as a football nation. I mean, just take us through some of the things that he said.
Hello, Morena. I think it was inevitable that the coach, Molefi Ntseki, will be sacked after his disappointing program, the program of failing to qualify the nation for next year's AFCON in Cameroon. Well, interestingly so, the CEO of SAFA was here, Tebogo Motlanthe, alongside the head of the SAFA Technical Committee, that is Mr. Maluleka, to take some of the questions. It's unfortunate that the SAFA president, Denis Jordan, was not here. He was the person that we were waiting to ask questions and get answers from. But in terms of what has transpired here, of course, as you mentioned, Molefi Ntseki has parted ways with the association with immediate effect. In fact, they had a meeting last night with him, and that's when the decision was taken. As to what's going to be happening in terms of the way forward, the SAFA Technical Committee still has to meet. In fact, they told us that they are going to meet after Easter to discuss the previous coach's report and then take a way forward in terms of selecting the next coach for Bafana Bafana. It is also worth noting that in terms of the next games for Bafana Bafana, the big one after, of course, the AFCON failure is the 2022 World Cup, which is very important. I cannot imagine the nation failing next year. There's two tournaments, that is AFCON and the World Cup, the nation failing to be present at those major events. It's going to be quite disappointing. But we asked questions in terms of when are we likely to hear the appointment of the new coach, but the technical committee told us that they still have to review the report and then come back to us, hopefully before the end of this month.
So, Tsepo, I know one of the questions that were asked, or rather statements that were said and questions that were asked, was that they made 53 million rands in surplus revenue. So finding a coach, a quality coach, that you can pay the money that maybe they will be asking for should not be a problem. I know you guys brought up the name of Benny McCarthy, who is the AmaZulu head coach. Gavin Hunt, of course, has been struggling with Kaizer Chiefs, and the former Bafana Bafana coach, Carlos Quiroz.
I mean, the CEO, Tebogo Motlanthe, promised us that the issue of money is not going to be a problem when it comes to appointing a new coach. So if we take his words, it remains to be seen if that's going to be the case. Because a good question that you're asking, because previously there's been a lot of talks that coach Molefi Ntseki was not getting, was a cheaper option for the National Association. It remains to be seen what's going to be happening next in terms of the appointment of a new coach. I mean, the coaches that you mentioned, they are experienced. Benny McCarthy, there's the likes of Pitso Mosimane, who, of course, he got a chance after the 2010 World Cup, but he was very successful with Sundowns, meaning winning a number of trophies. And now he's coaching one of the best teams in Africa, Al Ahly. It's going to be interesting to see the direction that they are going to take, that is the technical team, in terms of appointing a new coach. Do you go overseas? Do you go local? Do you stay locally or in Africa? It's going to be a big question. I mean, also the fact that there's no time in terms of from now till the next AFCON or 2022 World Cup qualifiers. Are coaches available? That's a big task for the SAFA Technical Committee.
Most definitely a big task. Tsepo Thobane, thank you very much. He is out at SAFA House, as our reporter Tsepo Thobane. He's been following this press conference and this major news that have been announced today, that Molefi Ntseki has been sacked because he failed to lead the country into Cameroon for AFCON 2022. We have about 5 months to go to the beginning of the World Cup qualifiers, and we don't have a head coach at the moment. The technical committee will meet next week to pave a way forward, so we will only but wait and see what is going to be happening. Gavin Hunt, Benny McCarthy, Carlos Quiroz, Pitso Mosimane, there was at one point a Herve Renard that was thrown around as a potential replacement. We can only but wait and see if they're going to be getting anybody who is of the right kind of quality to get us to Qatar next year. Tulas?